Hey everybody, it's Nick from Old Fashioned Knights, and today I'm going to show you my design for the beer hammer. Now the beer hammer is just a wooden mallet with a twist, the twist being that it's got a bottle opener on there, and occasionally when I've been drinking, I use send to crush cans. The beer hammer's handle is made out of maple, which is 3/4 inch thick. I created the handle in Carveco, my own design, and then I used my CNC machine to carve it out. The inner pieces are walnut, 3/4 inches, and the outer pieces are cherry. I also use my CNC machine to carve in the text beer hammer, and then I use my drill press with a Forstner bit to make the openings for the bottle opener. Now let's get the bill in the beer hammer. Because I have my handle and the CNC router, I can't get a straight 90 degree angle. And for my inner piece, that's going to be somewhat of a problem because I have it cut 90 degrees. So if you see here, there's some play because of that curvature is basically my 1/8 end mill bit. So what I'm going to do is take this inner piece to my palm router with the 1/8 round over bit, and I'm just going to run across that inner corner so I can get that to fit nice and snug inside here. And here's the results. Now with everything cut out, we can finally put together the hammer. Got all my pieces laid out. And now what I'm going to do is take the bottle opener end, and I'm going to flip it around. And what I've gone and done is already made a center line on the board. And I used that to align the handle. And once I've aligned the handle, I made a line on this side to know where I'm going to place my inner piece. So with that line there, I'm going to take my inner piece and I'm going to make sure I got the round over side going inwards like so. And I'm going to take that side and I'm going to apply glue and I'm going to spread it around in a nice even layer. All right. Now I'm going to take that side, and again with the round over side facing inward to the bottom, I'm going to align it to the line that I've placed. Also making sure that it's nice and aligned with the bottom piece. And actually, I'm going to use this piece of wood here to make sure that they're both aligned. Oh, I'd like them. Okay, so I like it like that. Now, to hold it in place and make things easier, I'm going to take my nail gun and I'm just going to go ahead and put a couple of nails through it to hold it in place. There we go. So apply glue to the other side. Lay that down. I'm just going to take my piece again, the round over side, going to the handle. And secure that. Now I'm going to take the top side and first glue pieces here. And I'm just going to align on this side. And there we go. I'm going to go ahead and let this dry. Using this bar straw to get rid of the excess glue on the inside and just clean it out.
Everything's glued together, so let's go ahead and cut it to its final lengths and clean it up. To make cutting the head of the hammer a little easier, I've gone ahead and grabbed a spare piece of wood, and what I did is put painter's tape on one side. I'm going to do the same here to the head of the hammer, and I'm going to use CA glue, and I'm going to glue it to the board. That'll allow me to have a little more surface area to hold the head of the hammer under my miter saw just to make it a little safer.
In addition to sanding everything, I've gone ahead and cut this wedge. And what I'm going to do is when I'm gluing up the hammer, I'm going to place the wedge in between the handle like so, knock it in place, and that'll hold it and give a little more strength.
Let's place glue on this part of the hammer. Get a little bit on there. Get some on the hilt inside. Get a little bit of everywhere. Spread it. Hammer head like so. Squeeze out . Wipe the excess glue. Now I probably put way too much glue, so use me as your reference of what not to do when gluing, but I'm wiping the excess off around the bottom here. And then that's on there. Now I'm going to put a little bit on the wedge. Through my fingers like so. And I'm going to place the wedge into the handle. And I'm going to grab a regular mallet, and I'm just gonna tap it in place a little bit. That should be good. Double check for any excess glue. Wipe it away. And we'll go ahead and let this dry.
The hammer has dried. Everything looks good. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut off the top wedge piece, sand it down, and then go ahead and do a little bit of finishing up and put some oil on it and call it done. beer hammer is now done, and as you can see, it works. So thanks for watching. If you're interested in seeing more of this content, please hit like, subscribe, do all that, and I'll see you again next time. Thanks.